In this video, we're going to discuss solid score lines. Now, as of roughly last November, that would be November of 2018, we began including solid score line versions of our projects. Now, in order to use solid score lines, you do need a machine that is capable of creating them. The two most common machines that we see creating these solid score lines include the Cricut Maker and the Eclipse 2. In this video, I'm going to show you how to determine which file is the solid score line version and also how to use it correctly. So let's take a look at one of our most recent projects that features solid score lines. In this case, we're going to be working with the Exquisite Gift Box. Okay, so let's take a look and open this file up. Now, it's already unzipped. Let me show you a picture of what it is. It's this guy here. It's this paper Fabergé egg. And after you get everything unzipped, just like usual, you'll see the main SVG folder. Let's go ahead and double click on it and take a look inside. So inside the main SVG folder, which is what we're looking at right now, again, it's the main SVG folder, the first level in, you're going to find the traditional perforated score lines. Typically, the solid score line folder is going to be located in the extras folder. There may be a handful of older projects that have the solid score lines in the solid score line folder directly in the SVG folder. Now, for the sake of this video, we're going to assume that the solid score line version of this project is located in the extras folder, which 99% of the time it will be. So again, if you double click on extras, you should find the solid score lines folder. Now let me show you how to use this in Cricut Design Space. Now, just as a side note, personally, based on experience, I really don't like using the solid score line version when creating structures, 3D objects. I prefer to only use them when you're scoring simple things like maybe the center of a card or an envelope where the aesthetic is really important. When you're creating some of our 3D projects, like the actual structure for the egg that ultimately is going to be hidden by panels, it's really not that important to use the solid score lines. And in most cases, the perforated version, not the solid score line version, will actually work better when it comes to folding. But either way, if you insist on using the solid score line version of anything that we create, here's how you would do that. So typically, when you open Design Space, you're going to be presented with this screen here. And you'll want to go to Upload, and you're going to upload these files just like you upload any of our files by clicking the Upload Image button here. And then we're going to Browse. Now at this point, what we need to do is locate the folder that contains the files that we wish to upload. Now in this case, we're working with the Exquisite Gift Box, so we need to open that up. And we're going to go into the SVG folder. And now again, if you want to use the solid score line version, you need to go into Extras. And then you also need to go into solid score lines. Okay, and here you can see we've got the entire project, but with an SS prefix. So we can go ahead and double click on the first one. And we'll get that loaded. We can hit save. And then obviously you want to upload all of the files required to create this project. So we're going to repeat the process and hit browse again and go to the next one. And hit save again. And you'll repeat this process until you have all of the files required to create this project uploaded. In this case, for this project, there's about 12, I think. So we go to the next one, and we're just going to continue down the row until we get them all in there. Now, there's one additional thing that you need to do to make sure that your machine is actually scoring these, and I'm going to show you how to do that. So let's just bring these in. So we're clicking on them so that they're selected here. You can see that they're selected because they have a little green stroke around the button. And we'll hit Insert Images. Okay, now I'm going to zoom out just a tad. And you can see that these are, in fact, solid score lines. Now, if you don't change them to score, your machine is actually going to cut this and you're going to end up with a huge mess because these are solid lines. If you don't tell your Cricut to actually score these, it will cut everything that you see here. So, in order to set or tell your Cricut that you want these lines to be scored, there's one simple thing that you need to do. I'm going to show you that right now. Now, if you take a look here under Layers, you'll see each file name here. This is the base of the actual egg that the egg sits on. And you can see here that this does have some solid score lines. So for each file, there are two layers. Okay, and you can see what I'm going to do now is I'm just going to turn one of these or two of these off just so that we can just focus on one. Okay, and it's this one here. And you can see when I click on it here, it highlights it here. And you'll notice that there are two layers underneath the file name. The first layer here almost looks like there's nothing there, but there in fact is. If we take and hide this layer or turn it off, you can see that it's actually the score layer, while this one here is the cut layer. Okay, so in order to tell your Cricut to score this, you need to select this layer by just clicking on it. Okay, if you click on it here, you're selecting the entire file, which you don't want to do. You only want to select the score layer here. And again, you can see that that's the score layer, because if we turn it off and on, it hides and shows the score layer. So with only the score layer selected for this file, now that we have it selected, we go up to line type up here on the top and change this to score. It's going to make the lines look perforated, but it in fact is going to score them with the score tool, so they will be solid score lines. Okay, so this one's almost ready to go. I do want to show you one other thing here. Now before you hit make it, there's one additional thing you need to do to make sure that the score lines line up with the actual cut. Now I'm going to show you what happens if you don't take this step. I'll show you what the step is in just a second, but let's just hit make it so you can see what happens here. What it's doing is it's putting the score marks on a separate mat. Okay, so you can see that the score marks are not here. And the reason for that is because you always have to make sure that if any of our files have score lines, that you highlight the entire file by just clicking on it, or you can click on it here on the main file name and click attach. Now by doing so, when you hit make it, you'll see that Design Space puts the score marks on the same mat as the actual cut file, which is what you want. Okay, so technically this file is ready to go. So we can put that off to the side for now, and let's turn on the other layers that we hid. I'll do one at a time here. And again, same process for this one. You'll notice if we just click here, it's going to select the entire file with both layers. We don't want that. We want to only select the score layer by clicking on the score layer here under the main file. You'll see if we turn it off and on that it hides and shows the score layer. So again, we want to select it, only the score layer, which is right here, and go under line type and set that to score. Okay, and again, we want to make sure that we select the entire file by clicking anywhere on the file or by clicking on the file name here so that both layers are selected, and click attach so that Design Space knows to keep the score lines lined up with the actual cut. And now if we hit make it, you'll see here on this mat, we've got the file along with the score lines. And it's okay that some of these score lines go beyond this little area. That's kind of a bleed feature just to make sure that we get the scoring all the way out to where it needs to be. So that's totally normal. Okay, so I'll show you that one more time. We'll put this over to the side and let's bring up this last one that I hid by just clicking the eyeball here. Okay, and again, we're going to select just the score layer, which is right here. And I'm just clicking on the eyeball to show you and to illustrate that we're just selecting the score layer. Okay, so we've got this layer selected here. It almost looks like there's nothing there, but there is. And we're going to go to line type and select score. And you know you have it right because it turns them into little perforated lines. Okay, and again, final step, we want to select the entire file either by clicking it here or by clicking on the name here and hitting attach. All right, now if we hit make it, we should have three mats, and we do, and they all have the score lines set to score, and you can see here that it also says score and then cut. So your machine is going to prompt you to insert your score tool, and then it's going to have you take that out, put in the blade, so it can actually cut the cut portion. And that is pretty much it. Now I do want to show you one other thing here. So if you don't have a Cricut Maker or the Explore with the old-fashioned score tool, you'll want to go and upload the standard version. So if we go to browse, We're going to go back onto the desktop and open up the exquisite gift box again, go into the main SVG folder, and these files here without the SS prefix are the traditional perforated score marks. So these are going to cut with your actual blade. You do not want to use the score tool for these. So let's open up the first one here, and I'm just going to show you one, and you can see right off the bat, let me bring this in, so you can see right off the bat that these lines here are already perforated. You don't need to change anything under the line type. All you need to do is just hit attach, and then when you hit make it, you'll see that the score lines are there. These score lines are going to cut. You'll notice that there's only a cut here. There's no score, but the machine is going to create these score marks by cutting them. We're just using the blade, one tool, to do the perimeter cuts as well as the perforated lines that you would see on kind of like a ticket stub. Okay, so just to recap again, if you have the Cricut Maker and you want to use the rotary score tool, you want to use the files that begin with SS. You can see that here under layers. It begins with SS. The traditional perforated score lines do not have the SS, and these are going to be cut with your actual blade, the perforated lines, where with this, it is actually going to score with the score tool. So I hope that makes sense. If you have any additional questions, you can contact me by visiting the contact page on my website, 3dsvg.com.